Hello, welcome to Q's with A's, and today we're going to do something a little different. We're going to be standing this video to show our appreciation for people with ALS and how they don't have the chance to do the little things that we get to do every day, like stand and use our arms and stuff like that. And today I'm going to call in one of my family members, my grandmother, and we're going to talk about some of the things that Maury talked about in his interview with Ted Koppel. And we're going to get her view on some of the things that Maury talked about and how she thinks of it. All right, see you later in the video.
All right, guys, I'm going to be interviewing my mother on the phone, and the first question I'm going to ask her is, what about your life has been worth living?
That's a hard question. I don't know. Is another question you can ask me, or is that the question that you have to ask?
Well, that's one of the questions we have.
I guess watching my children grow up and become their own individual person was baggage for me, but still doing independently at the same time.
Okay. So what do you think you're living or have lived your, do you think you've lived your best life so far? Or you're living it right now?
It's more to come. I'm still working on becoming the best me, so without becoming the best me, it's going to be hard to live the best life that I feel I should really be living.
Do you think there's a certain age where you should have lived your best life?
No, I think that people have different obstacles and barriers, and so they overcome different things at different times in their life.
I agree.
It's never too late to start.
All right. What event in your life has impacted you the most, and why?
Is it like the change with me? You talking about like a change in me in general, or just a change?
I mean, it can be like a death. It can be like a job. It could be anything that has impacted your life in a major way.
I think when I had a near-death experience a couple years ago, it made me reevaluate how I deal with things.
That's great. That's great because it shows people that, you know, even things like that can really change you as a person. And do you regret any choices you made and why?
Yes and no, because I feel like every choice I made made me the person I am. When I say yes, I mean some things I probably could have did later or did differently, but the outcomes are okay. So like with my situation a couple years ago when I had that experience, I probably should have paid attention to the warning signs before, but I was still trying to be goal-oriented, go to school, go to work, take care of my kids, I wasn't paying attention. But now I know that I have to be proactive because I have people to look towards, you know, I have to take care of them. I have to be here for.
Yeah. So another question I have is, from when you were a child and an adult, do you still look up to the same people or do you look up to different people?
I think I've added, because along the way you'll find people that you will add to, that you admire. For different reasons, whether it's their strengths or their testimony of life that they've occurred, you know, similar to yours, or maybe not similar, but overcame and made you, encouraged you to do better in your life. I still have the same people that I did before. I just added to it, like my dad, because he was a single parent raising us. My grandfather, and the women in my life that were there because I didn't have a mother. But I still have different people that I look up to that I've met along the way.
So what are your views on family, and is it important to you?
It is, but I look at family as beyond blood, because some people are family that aren't blood relatives.
Do you think love and heartbreak are a good experience to have in life?
everybody should experience. Well, Arlene was experience love. Sometimes the heartbreak helps you reevaluate yourself. It's not, I'm not saying that I won't want like my children to experience heartbreak, but it does help you reevaluate yourself.
Mm-hmm.
All right, which point in your life did you find yourself, like, who you wanted to be?
Probably, sophomore year, freshman, sophomore year, because I know prior to that I wanted to do something totally different than what I ended up doing. I still want to be a lawyer, that changed.
Mm-hmm.
When I was younger, before I got
in high school. Alright, so what is the meaning of life to you?
Sorry, what was that?
What is the meaning of life to you?
I do believe that you should live it to the fullest of your fullest, not other people. That's a question I don't really have an answer to. What's the meaning of life?
That's kind of a hard question to answer.
Yeah, without thinking about it, it's hard to sit there and just say, this is what I think the meaning of life is. Yeah.
And our final question to wrap up our interview through the phone is, do you think you'll live a meaningful life before your death?
I think I'm living a meaningful life now. It's just gonna get, I'm just gonna have different parts. I think different phases is gonna come up. I'm still working on my career, so then when that phase goes, then I'll probably have the career that I choose to have. I mean, I chose the one I have now, but every career you have different goals, and I'm working on towards my next goal. And with my family, just different relationships, many different relationships, building different relationships, even within my marriage as well. So,
right.
I think it's always evolving.
Well, thank you. That was a great answer. And thank you for interviewing with me today.